No, but IELTS. So I need to know how far you guys familiar with the IELTS exam. Because again, I'm not going to teach you from the very beginning of IELTS.
Hai
Anyway,
Kak,
yeah, hi.
Nasriati.
Yeah.
Kalau menurut saya IELTS itu ini apa namanya sebuah apa ya? Gimana ngejelasinnya? Kayak untuk tes bahasa Inggris gitu loh Kak, buat mengetahui seberapa seberapa bisa kita dalam berbahasa Inggris dan juga IELTS itu digunakan untuk tes kita untuk misalnya mengetahui kemampuan bahasa Inggris kita bisa juga digunakan untuk buat pendaftaran beasiswa gitu Kak, maupun baik di dalam negeri ataupun di luar atau bisa juga untuk digunakan untuk bekerja
I
sama
see.
kayak misalnya TOEFL gitu. Mungkin itu Kak.
So before, as you know, joining this IELTS class, so you have already you know, taken IELTS course? Sudah pernah ngambil IELTS sebelumnya? Maksudnya kursusnya? Have you?
Sementara sih Kak, tapi baru juga masih masih awal banget.
Yeah, because there was someone who informed me that, oh, we had a class, IELTS course, and then we weren't satisfied enough, and we need to know more. He just told me that it indicated that she's already full aware of what IELTS is, and I don't think it's necessary for me to teach them, or in this class, in this case, her, you know, very basic IELTS. So this free class IELTS only offers a practice for you guys and not the some kind of guidance how to achieve very high IELTS score, which means that do not expect too much because again this is also free. If you're ready, then I think I will show you the PowerPoint that I would like to show to you to make sure that you guys you know, can practice it right now, right away. Should we wait for everybody to come? Because I don't think 3 are enough. Many people responded to my text more than 3, so I assume that there will be more people to come. So which one do you guys prefer? Should I speak in English all the time or mix or even in full Bahasa Indonesia, it's up to you. But I feel more confident and I think it's better for you to practice your listening when you listen to the tutor speaking in English. So it's up to you. But I'm gonna hear you. Do you, well, which one do you like better? Bahasa Indonesia or English? Anyone? Which one do you think it suits better with your learning preference? Jadi gimana? Do you want me to speak Indonesian or English? Up to you.
Both, Kak. Keduanya.
Yeah, maybe I can speak in English and then when you don't understand, maybe I can say it in Bahasa Indonesia, right?
Okay.
Okay, what should I say to this? This will be recorded, guys. So I think you guys know from that recording notification that you get before you come here. How should I start? Okay. Okay, before we start, is there any question? Sebelumnya, mungkin Khairul Bahri atau Nasriati mau bertanya dulu sebelum kita masuk ke materi. Yeah. Again, guys, this is free IELTS class. So make the most of it. Ini tuh kelas IELTS gratis. Jadi manfaatkan sebaik-baiknya. Kalau bertanya, silakan. Tanya saja. If you want to interrupt me, that's fine. Just say it nicely, okay? Yeah? Nasriati, I see you are unmute. I think you would like to say a word or two.
Kak mau tanya, ini ada silabusnya gitu kakak untuk pembelajarannya atau gimana sistemnya?
Syllabus, I think because this is a free class, so I think you only receive what I'm ready for, what I have prepared before. So maybe I can provide the syllabus for you to make sure that you feel, you know, better for, you know, preparing yourself for the upcoming lessons. But I think it's not necessary yet. Maybe I can make it later, but not for now. Because basically you will only learn or practice about listening and reading and of course writing and also speaking, and I will explain it to you later. Okay. But I want to ask you a question, Nasreti. Why do you want to know about the syllabus?
Kak, gimana? Boleh diulang, Kak?
Why do you know about the syllabus? Why do you want to know about the syllabus?
Karena biar harusnya biar tahu di awal tuh mau belajar apa gitu.
I see.
Ini kan free gitu kak, atau bebas aja gitu sembarang mau misalnya mau apa misalnya listening dulu kak gitu kak, atau gimana terserah gitu kak, atau gimana ya kak, maksudnya mau jelasin aja.
Yeah, that's a very very excellent question. Karena gini, I just want to deliver the lesson to you and then you receive it, mostly about the receptive skills and not the productive skills. I will explain that later. Jadi mungkin silabus itu lebih kayak oh nanti kita mau ngapain ini terus kita prepare nih buat nanti. Tapi sebenarnya IELTS dimanapun itu latihannya sama aja. Listening, nanti mungkin reading, habis itu writing, habis itu speaking. Karena di ujian IELTS, ya seperti itu. Jadi kita, so we're going to come to the, for example, British Council, and then we'll sit in front of the computer, if you take the computer IELTS. So we're going to listen to the listening questions, all the conversations in the listening sections. And then after that, we will have the reading exam. And after that, we'll have the writing exam. And after that, the last section is the speaking one. Jadi jalurnya memang gitu terus. Listening, habis itu writing, reading, habis itu writing, habis itu speaking. Jadi untuk silabus mungkin tidak perlu khawatir ya, karena ya itu lagi kalau IELTS segitu-gitu aja. Yang perlu kamu lakukan adalah mungkin lebih banyak, you know, you need to immerse yourself in English atmosphere. Jadi misalkan listening to podcast in English, speaking English all the time, probably even with yourself. Or you can come here and listen to my speaking and practice your listening and reading in here together with your friends, even if you don't know them in here. But there's always something that you can do to improve your English skill. So when you have your IELTS exam, it will be ready. You will be just fine. Kalau misalkan sudah terbiasa dari dengerin bahasa Inggris, terus praktis terus bahasa Inggris, exam akan terasa lebih ringan karena sudah banyak bekalnya. Jadi ada silabus atau tidak ada silabus, just come here because it's free. Kita I think but that's a very good question, actually, because we all need to know what we're going to do each meeting, right? Karena kita harus tahu setiap meeting itu mau ngapain aja. Tapi for now, I just want to confirm to you that it will be fine.
Okay, Kak. Thanks.
Okay, welcome, Macy. Selamat datang.
Yeah,
okay. Hi.
Terima kasih.
Sebelum, before we start, do you have any question?
Sebenarnya info di grup itu kayaknya kurang menginformasikan karena saya tidak tahu gitu. Tiba-tiba udah ada ini link gitu. Mungkin teman-teman lain kan nggak join karena nggak tahu juga mungkin.
No, karena ini pertemuan pertama dan because this is the first meeting, and then I wasn't really prepared for the first one. I was going to make this class at 7 p.m. in Indonesia, WIB, but then it was all too late. Kalau misal, sedangkan saya, I was preparing the PowerPoint, so if I postpone it again, it will be getting more late. Jadi lebih larut lagi di Indonesia nanti. Makanya langsung.
Okay.
Makanya next meeting, kalau misalkan PowerPoint sudah siap, materi sudah siap, pasti akan di notif duluan. Mungkin sehari sebelumnya.
Oh, okay, Kak. Terima kasih.
Tapi untuk first meeting, it's okay. Semoga next meeting banyak yang lebih yang datang lebih banyak ya, maksudnya. Because we can see from the response, we've got 7 people and now we have only 4. Well, I think, but they can always watch the recording later. Jadi rekamannya semoga membantu. Okay, can you guys type something on here on the chat? Say where you from. Daerahnya di mana? Sorry guys, I just woke up. No, not woke up. Ini sebenarnya bangun tidur tadi jam 9 dan terus. And then I went to the gym. I just walked 1 minute from my flat to the gym. So I make sure that you guys can listen to my speaking because I need you to get used to the English speaking. However, I will definitely speak in Bahasa Indonesia if you don't understand. Sorry guys, you know my laptop always like that, always works so slowly. So tell me where you're from, guys. Type on the chat box and let me know.
Kayaknya chatnya nggak bisa ya, Kak?
Are you sure?
Ya udah saya coba
nggak bisa ini kak.
Why? I don't know. Maybe the setting. I will figure out. Coba coba nanti saya kasih. Okay. But can you see my chat?
Yes.
What happens? Maybe I can figure out the setting later. Okay. So let's get into it. Oh, ini penting saya ketahui dulu guys sebelum kita mulai. Tadi Maria tuh menjelaskan tentang betapa dia tahu tentang IELTS. Dan saya hanya, you know, I just want to respond to that because I don't want to teach you IELTS from the beginning. So we're going to go straight to the IELTS practice. And of course, just like I told you, we start from the listening. Jadi bagi yang belum tahu apa itu IELTS atau benar-benar nol, saya sarankan untuk mungkin nanti tonton video. I think I made a video about how you guys need to know about what IELTS is. Maybe I can think about that. Okay. Let's share my screen. This is green. Oh, not this one. I'm sorry, guys. What the hell? I definitely need a new laptop. You know, because sometimes the Wi-Fi always disconnect with the computer. Share screen. Where is your screen? What's going on? I don't know which button. Oh, this one, share. Oh. Not responding again. Okay. So welcome. Okay, can you see my eyes, guys? Can you see my screen?
Yeah, Kak.
Okay. You don't have to always call me Kak. Anyway, you can call me Ega or Erlanga. That's fine. You know, in English, there's no something. There's no boundaries.
Enggak sopan
Yeah, in Bahasa Indonesia it's not really polite, but in English it's fine. I even call my professor by their name. If the professor name is Stefan, then I will call him Stefan, even if he's older than me, and also even if he's a professor. Yeah, meskipun professor ataupun lecturer gitu, dosen, tetap manggilnya nama. Kecuali kalau dia dokter, yang pengen dipanggil dokter, biasanya ya, harus dipanggil dokter. Tapi ya, di sini budaya gitu, jadi panggil nama aja. Oke. Okay. Oops. Yeah. Di IELTS itu sendiri ada receptive dan productive skills. Listening, reading termasuk receptive, sedangkan writing dan speaking termasuk productive. What we're doing here, so we're going to practice a lot of listening and reading questions or, you know, exercises. Jadi selama masih bisa, saya akan berikan itu secara gratis. Tetapi untuk yang productive, writing dan speaking itu memerlukan feedback. Dan biasanya karena feedback itu lebih banyak mikir dan juga banyak menyita waktu. So I'm going to spend a lot of time and thoughts to give you a very constructive feedback. So there will be no free feedback, unfortunately. However, you are very welcome to come here to practice your listening and reading. Jadi, bukan berarti karena tidak ada free feedback, kalian langsung berhenti di kelas ini. Sekali lagi, kelas ini gratis. Tapi kalau ingin yang lebih personal feedbacknya, try to consider to donate maybe to the tutors. I won't charge you very much. Just I won't, you know, charge you just about, you know, not very expensive. Tapi selama kelas ini masih dibuka, jadi datang aja. Gak perlu mikirin apakah you can afford it or not. Selama reading dan listening itu bisa membantu, just come. Okay, you don't need to think about how you can afford it or not, and then after that you don't want to come because it's probably you don't have the money. It's okay. Dalam nanti kita akan practice writing dari cara menyusun essay, karena writing itu kan ada dua, write task one and task two. Nah, di task 1 and task 2, kita akan belajar essay dari introduction sampai conclusion. Nah, you don't have to think about how you can pay for the feedback. Think about how you can do it with yourself first. Jadi, pikirkan bagaimana cara nanti bisa menyusun essay untuk writing task 1 and task 2. Jangan terlalu mikirin bagaimana caranya bisa bayar untuk feedback dari tutor. Karena kalau Anda tidak butuh feedback, it's okay. It means that you don't need to pay for me. Tapi seenggaknya kalian dapat knowledge di sini untuk tahu caranya membuat esai yang lebih baik dan lebih tersusun, rapi. So, you don't need to doubt. You don't need to do that, okay guys? If you stay in here, please consider a few things. Donate to the tutor if you can. If you cannot, that's fine. Be here, practice your English, practice your speaking, practice your listening, practice your reading and everything here, including your writing. Do not think about how you can afford it. Okay, just be here. Datang aja di sini. If you can help me with the YouTube monetization, for example, you can absolutely subscribe to the tutorial channel, because I think monetization could help the tutors, you know, financial help. I think ya, saat seorang sudah dimonetize, biasanya ada penghasilan di situ. Jadi you don't, so it's free. You can just click the subscribe. Maybe I think that's all the ways to help me to survive in here. Jadi I help you with the IELTS, and then you help me with something that I can use in here to survive in the UK. Jadi kita saling membantu. And then please consider never stop learning, guys. Use everything that I offer in here, okay? And I will give you more materials if you're ready. But for now, we're going to practice from the very small set. Yep. Okay. So the next slide will be about the IELTS practice. But before we start the practice, I'm going to ask you a question, guys. Are you ready to practice your first listening? Or do you have any questions? Before we start. Jadi ada pertanyaan? Intinya guys, receptive skill, listening and reading, kalian bisa praktis di sini kapanpun. Dan untuk yang productive skill, speaking dan writing, kalian terserah mau butuh feedback atau tidak. Itu balik lagi kepada kalian. Dan sekalipun pengen feedback dari tutornya, jika kalian cannot afford, then that's fine. Just never stop learning in here if you can. Ada pertanyaan sebelum kita practice? Or are you guys ready to practice the listening for the first time in this class? Ada pertanyaan, Messi, Katsumi, kakak-kakak, mari. Okay, so are you? So it means right. It means that you guys are ready for the first listening practice. Can you see my screen? Or maybe it's best for me to send this. Okay, how about this one? If you guys have practiced the listening with that question, with those type of questions, I cannot recommend you to continue because IELTS exam or IELTS practice will be pretty much the same. It will not be different in any type of way. So I'm sorry if it's the same. Ada yang sudah pernah latihan IELTS dengan question tersebut? Jika sudah, maybe you can skip it. Karena seperti yang saya bilang, IELTS itu, ya praktisnya itu-itu aja gitu loh. Maksudnya, ya belajarnya itu-itu aja. So, be here to discuss with your friends. Maybe you can get different perspective from how your friends answer this question. Okay? Jadi mungkin di sini setelah praktis, akan dapat perspektif yang berbeda dari teman-teman. Oh, dia tekniknya menjawab pertanyaan ini begini. Dia jawabnya seperti ini. Jadi, membuka perspektif baru untuk trik dalam menjawab question di listening section. Okay. Lebih baik, listening, share question again. Kayaknya lebih jelas gitu. Lebih jelas gimana ya. Or maybe like this one. Can you see my screen? Ini lebih. Okay.
IELTS 17, published by Cambridge University Press and Assessment 2022. This recording is copyright. Test 1. This is the IELTS listening test. You will hear a number of different recordings, and you will have to answer questions on what you hear. There will be time for you to read the instructions and questions, and you'll have a chance to check your work.
Okay. Did you hear the audio? Audionya kedengaran?
Iya, Kak.
Okay, before we start, well, we already started, but apa yang harus Anda lakukan di listening? Apakah langsung baca questionnya atau apa? What do you know, guys? Gak ada jawaban benar atau salah. Saya hanya ingin tahu bagaimana trik kalian dalam menyelesaikan listening. Dalam menghadapi question di listening section. Anyone can share their opinion. Gimana sih caranya? Atau langsung dengerin dan nggak usah baca atau what?
Terus saya kak itu lihat soalnya dulu. Jadi kalau misalnya saya sudah mulai listeningnya,
baru oke. Okay.
Iya kak.
Nice. Ada yang lain? Oke, tips dari saya adalah jika listening ada instructionnya, jangan baca yang lain dulu, dengarkan instructionnya. Biasanya kalau dulu takutnya di tahun depan ada lagi peraturan yang berbeda, jadi ada example. Tapi dari tahun 2019 sampai sekarang IELTS listening itu nggak ada example ya. Kita harus lihat dulu one word and or a number for each. Berarti cuma satu kata. Jangan mencoba menjawab lebih dari dua kata. Seperti misalkan big house. Itu kan dua kata. Mungkin jawabannya cuma house atau big. Ya, jadi harus dipertimbangkan baik-baik. Nah, biasanya listening itu selalu urut sih guys. Jadi jangan khawatirnya. Dan selalu dengarkan instruction dari, biasa nanti ada regular activities. Di sini ada natural reserve. Dan kalau disuruh baca 1-5, ya udah baca 1-5. Jangan baca keseluruhan, nanti fokusnya hilang. Ya, di sini kan part 1 itu biasanya memang sampai 10 question atau mungkin lebih. Ada yang disuruh baca cuma sampai 1-5 atau 1-10 langsung gitu ada. So make sure you guys really listen to the instruction carefully.
All the recordings will be played once only. The test is in 4 parts. At the end of the test, you will be given 10 minutes to transfer your answers to the answer sheet. Now turn to part 1.
Oke, okay, kalian harus siap notes dengan pulpen atau pensil. Kita nanti akan bahas jawaban nomor 1-10, oke? Okay? Dan lihat berapa benar kalian. Oke? Okay? Are you guys ready?
Part 1. You will hear a woman called Jan phoning a man about their local conservation group. First, you have some time to look at questions 1-5. Now listen carefully and answer questions 1-5.
Hello?
Oh, hello. My name's Jan. Are you the right person to talk to about the Buckworth Conservation Group?
Yes, I'm Peter. I'm the secretary.
Good. I've just moved to this area and I'm interested in getting involved. I was in a similar group where I used to live. Could you tell me something about your activities, please?
Of course. Well, we have a mixture of regular activities and special events. One of the regular ones is trying to keep the beach free of litter. A few of us spend a couple of hours a month on it, and it's awful how much there is to clear. I wish people would be more responsible and take it home with them.
I totally agree. I'd be happy to help with that. Is it okay to take dogs?
I'm afraid not, as they're banned from the beach itself. You can take them along the cliffs, though, and children are welcome.
Right.
We also manage a nature reserve, and there's a lot to do there all year round. For example, because it's a popular place to visit, we spend a lot of time looking after the paths and making sure they're in good condition for walking.
I could certainly help with that.
Good. And we have a program of creating new habitats there. We've just finished making and installing nesting boxes for birds to use. And next, we're going to work on encouraging insects. They're important for the biodiversity of the reserve.
They certainly are.
Oh, and we're also running a project to identify the different species of butterflies that visit the reserve. You might be interested in taking part in that.
Sure. I was involved in something similar where I used to live, counting all the species of moths. I'd enjoy that.
Another job we're doing at the reserve is replacing the wall on the southern side, between the parking area and our woodshed. It was badly damaged in a storm last month.
Okay.
Okay, before we continue, let's discuss it first. Sebelum lanjut ya. Take it easy, guys. Baru 5 question. Apa kalian jawab semuanya? Kalian berhasil jawab semuanya nggak? Anyone? Hello? Did you guys make it to answer the all of these 5 questions? Berhasil jawab semuanya, 5-5-nya? It's okay.
Kak, sorry nggak bisa ikutan karena ini di depan rumah ada apa suara-suara ini.
Okay, yang lain, did you guys make make it to answer the questions? No. Anybody? So in answering the listening as well, you must pay attention to the synonyms or maybe the antonyms, but probably about the synonyms. They use the same words, I mean different words that have the same meaning. Katsumi, Hero, Marietu, Nasrati. How many questions did you guys manage to answer?
Maaf kak, belum jawab, ketinggalan.
Semuanya belum jawab? Atau satu atau dua? It's okay. Ini baru ada 3 parts or 4 parts in listening. Dan yang part 1 itu yang paling mudah, guys. So I cannot imagine you guys later. Ya, ada 4. Jadi kalian harus berhati-hati. Saya pikir kalian udah familiar dengan IELTS. That's why I didn't give you the very basic knowledge of IELTS. I think I have a video that discuss about the IELTS. It's very basic. Anybody? Marietto, did you manage to answer the questions? Or do you want me to repeat the audio? Hello, everyone. Please discuss this with your friends. Or discuss this with me. If you cannot tell me what you're struggling with, then I don't know how to help you. You're the one who needs help. I'm here to help. But if you don't tell me what you're struggling with, then I have no clue what to help. Kalian yang butuh pertolongan in IELTS. So I'm here to help. Jadi saya di sini untuk membantu. Tapi kalau kalian tidak tahu apa yang kalian alami dalam kesusahan menghadapi IELTS, saya tidak, I don't know what to do. Oke. Okay. Jadi apa susahnya? Apa susahnya atau apa kendalanya dalam menjawab part one listening. Kenapa tidak jawab semuanya, atau kenapa cuma satu jawaban gitu. Just consult with me, that's fine.
Kak, saya Mas Reti. Kalau untuk saya sendiri, sebetulnya karena mungkin pemula juga ya, dan bukan basic Inggris, maksudnya vocab-nya juga masih kurang banget, terus langsung mau belajar IELTS tuh rasanya agak sulit gitu nah Kak, jadi kayak masih kendala ini ngomong apa ya, terus udah sampai mana ya gitu loh Kak, jadi kayak terus mau langsung belajar IELTS tuh rasanya kayaknya enggak, kayaknya jangan dulu ya Kak atau gimana ya, kayak gitu loh Kak, jadi belum paham ini gimana gitu.
Sebenarnya kelas IELTS ini memang diperuntukkan untuk orang yang udah tahu IELTS gitu. Makanya tidak diajarkan dari awal IELTS. Dan bukan diajarkan basic bahasa Inggris. Dan memang itu tujuannya IELTS untuk yang orang yang udah paham IELTS. Jadi kalau memang perkendalanya di situ ya it's okay. Cuman saya di sini tuh kuliahnya jauh lebih berat. IELTS itu sebenarnya masih nggak ada apa-apanya sama kuliah di UK sekarang. Karena saya baru ngerasain setelah satu semester selesai, susahnya minta ampun. Jadi kalau misalkan mau IELTS tapi untuk di Indonesia mungkin masih bisa dapat nilai 5 atau 4, tapi di sini harus minimal 6,5. So, gimana ya? IELTS memang seperti itu, jadi nggak bisa dipermudah gitu. That's why I start this class in English, because I assume that you guys already familiar with that. I guess still, are you guys still sure that you want to do this? Because IELTS is IELTS, nggak bisa dipermudah dan nggak bisa dipersulit. Karena memang IELTS gitu-gitu aja. IELTS itu ujian terakhir untuk bahasa Inggris sebenarnya. Kalau udah punya IELTS ya udah, kita tahu seberapa jauh pemahaman kita terhadap bahasa Inggris.
Saya mau nanya nih Kak.
Ya. Yeah.
Jadi kan memang alhamdulillah sejauh ini udah hampir beberapa bulan untuk belajar IELTS gitu, sampai merelakan untuk resign juga gitu kan. Tapi memang banyak distraction yang kendala-kendala kayak hal-hal yang mengganggu kita untuk belajar. Nah, terkait untuk peningkatan IELTS-nya itu kesulitannya itu kayak nggak nilai itu nggak naik-naik gitu Kak. Padahal namanya tips and trick-nya itu udah tahu, semua kuncinya itu udah tahu, tapi susah untuk menaikkan nilainya gitu Kak. Kata orang itu butuh waktu 1 tahun untuk menaikkan 0,5. Itu apa betul atau enggak Kak?
Iya betul. Saya aja prepare sampai 1 tahun. Mungkin bagi yang punya otaknya encer kayak aku sih sampai 1 tahun lebih waktu itu untuk bisa naikin nilai, dan sampai sekarang di UK karena nggak semua orang tuh gimana ya mudah paham gitu dengan bahasa Inggris, sedangkan semua IELTS itu kan semua elemennya dinilai dari grammar, cohesion, accuracy, fluency, banyak. Jadi memang sulit sih. Tapi intinya adalah jangan berhenti untuk praktis gitu. Kalau nonton film pun ya yang bahasa Inggris dengan mungkin teks bahasa Inggris bukan teks terjemahan, atau lagu bahasa Inggris, dengerin Spotify, nonton YouTube pun YouTube yang bahasa Inggris tanpa subtitle. Tapi caption English, Jadi bisa lihat susunan grammarnya. Oh, saat dia ngomong kayak gini, kata-katanya gini gitu. Captionnya English ya, jadi bukan yang Indonesian subtitle gitu. Itu bisa sih membantu. Karena yang tadi saya bilang di awal, immerse yourself itu adalah benar-benar kita meresapi apa yang kita dengar, kita ucapkan, kita tulis, kita baca, semua dalam bahasa Inggris. Dan IELTS itu emang nggak bisa secepat itu sih. Kecuali kalau kita punya otak yang benar-benar encer dan benar-benar genius gitu, pasti lebih gampang. Cuman yang nggak semua orang seperti itu kan, termasuk saya. Saya ini masuk di UK ini sebenarnya nilainya itu pas-pasan banget. Nggak lebih, nggak kurang. Jadi pas banget segitu. 6,5 ya udah, saya dapat 6,5. Nah, makanya di sini kelas free IELTS class. This is not a general English class. So I really need your honesty. Saya perlu tahu kalian tuh tadi yang latihan tadi listening, susahnya tuh di mana? Dan memang banyak distraction, tapi try to be in your own room, for example, or in a very quiet place. There is no distraction at all, because this class is something that you want, not what I want. Okay, jadi gimana saya tahu kesusahan kalian, terus kasih tipsnya. Kalau misalnya kalian aja nggak tahu kesusahannya di mana, apa susahnya, nanti biar saya kasih tahu, mungkin bisa membantu. So, for example, Madia Tulfa, how many question did you answer? Berapa question yang tadi berhasil dijawab dari 1 sampai 5? Atau
ya? Maaf Kak, saya nggak jawab semua.
Oh, kenapa?
Jujur, saya lemahnya di listening, Kak.
Okay, di listening. Mungkin kita pelan-pelan kali ya, nomor satu misalkan, oh jawabannya apa. Kalau Katsumi, listening-nya, ada berhasil jawab atau sama sekali juga tidak? Kalau menurut saya guys, kalau kalian memang benar-benar pengen kuliah ke luar negeri ataupun di dalam negeri dengan IELTS, stop making excuses. Kalau kalian lemah di listening, it's fine. Tapi jangan give in. Jangan give up. Oh, saya lemah di listening, saya lemah di reading. Ah, udahlah berhenti practice. Ya, makin lemah nanti. Saya lemah di writing, guys. Dan di IELTS itu, nilai paling rendah saya adalah writing. Kesalahannya adalah, saya selalu menghindari latihan writing. Nah, di sini, kalian dapat tips dari seorang yang emang udah istilahnya teruji gitu loh guys, sampai di UK seperti sekarang ini, karena jangan sampai kalian berhenti di kelemahan kalian tapi terus latihan. Awalnya mungkin is, you know, terrifying, menakutkan, tapi lama-kelamaan pasti kalian bisa. Kita akan bahas dari nomor satu ya. Oke, okay, nomor satu, Maria itu bisa dibaca soalnya apa? Kita lihat di share screen. Oke. Okay. Atau siapa yang mau baca nomor satu?
You will hear a woman.
Oh, did you hear the audio? Kalau tadi conversation-nya ada berapa orang? Hello? Halo. Tadi conversation-nya ada berapa orang? Tadi listening-nya gimana? Ada beberapa orang? Ada berapa orang maksudnya? Halo.
Dua ya? Kalau yeah. Untuk di part 1 itu dua orang.
Ya, yeah, betul. Oke, okay, kita jawab nomor satu dulu ya. Making sure the beach does not have blank on it.
Called Jan, phoning a man about their local conservation group. First, you have some time to look at questions 1 to 5.
Jadi nomor 1 sampai nomor 5 dibaca. Karena itu instruction-nya. Ya. Kalau instruction-nya ngomong seperti itu, silakan dijalani.
Now listen carefully and answer questions 1 to 5.
Hello?
Oh, hello. My name's Jan. Are you the right person to talk to about the Buckworth Conservation Group?
Yes, I'm Peter. I'm the secretary.
Good. I've just moved to this area and I'm interested in getting involved. I was in a similar group where I used to live. Could you tell me something about your activities, please?
Of course. Well, we have a mixture of regular activities and special events. One of the regular ones is trying to keep the beach free of litter.
What's the answer?
Litter.
Yeah, litter. Kenapa jawabannya litter?
Tadi ada bilang nggak apa dipastikan tidak ada sampah ya sekitaran pantai tapi.
Yeah. Apa kalimat yang cowok itu bilang? Masih ingat? Coba ya. Here.
Yeah, okay.
Person to talk to about the Buckworth Conservation Group.
Yes, I'm Peter. I'm the secretary.
Good. I've just moved to this area and I'm interested in getting involved. I was in a similar group where I used to live.
Ini cuman dia, ceweknya bilang similar group tapi dia pengen different activities ya.
Could you tell me something about your activities, please?
Of course. Well, we have a mixture of regular activities and special events. One of the regular ones is trying to keep the beach free of litter.
Trying to keep? Trying to keep
the beach?
Beach free.
Beach?
Trying to keep the beach free. Apakah sama dengan making sure the beach does not have?
Sama-sama.
Sama. Nah, di listening itu gitu. Jadi, pertanyaannya pasti berbeda. Tapi intinya sama. Kita harus paham sama sinonim ya, guys. Jadi, si Peter bilang, one of the regular ones is trying to keep the beach free of litter. Litter itu sampah ya. Trash.
A few of us spend a couple of hours a month on it, and it's awful how much there is to clear. I wish people would be more responsible and take it home with them.
I totally agree. I'd be happy to help with that. Is it okay to take dogs?
I'm afraid not.
Ah. Nomor dua. Gak boleh ada apa? Hello. Nggak boleh ada apa? No. What?
No. Bring pet ya? Yeah. Eh, bukan.
Yeah. Tag benar? Tag apa?
Nggak terlalu dengar. Boleh diulang lagi, Kak?
Coba.
Get home with them.
I totally agree. I'd be happy to help with that. Is it okay to take dogs?
I'm afraid not.
Yeah.
No.
Dog. Huh?
Dog. Exactly. Dog. Kenapa dogs?
Kenapa tidak boleh.
Karena si Peter bilang.
Karena.
I'm afraid.
Saya tidak terlalu fokus.
I'm afraid not.
Okay.
Jadi si si ceweknya itu bilang, si Jane namanya. Is it okay to take dog? Katanya boleh nggak sih bawa dogs gitu. Terus si Peter bilang, I'm afraid not.
Paham, oh,
maaf, maaf nggak boleh gitu jadi. So number 3, 4, 5, coba dijawab ya. Nanti kita bahas.
As they're banned from the beach itself, you can take them along the cliffs though, and children are welcome.
Right.
We also manage a nature reserve, and there's a lot to do there all year round. For example, because it's a popular place to visit, we spend a lot of time looking after the paths and making sure they're in good condition for walking.
Di sini kita punya nature reserve. Yang pertama, maintaining paths. Yang tadi si Peter bilang, look after. Kalian tahu look after? Look after itu sama kayak take care, guys. Look after, take care, dan jadilah maintain. Maintain, jadi mereka kata-kata, frasa atau kata-kata ini sama, punya kemiripan. Jadi nomor satu, jadi nomor satu kegiatan nature reserve-nya sudah disebutkan. Oke. Okay. Lalu nomor dua.
I could certainly help with that.
Good. And we have a program of creating new habitats there. We've just finished making and installing nesting boxes for birds to use.
Nomor dua, apakah sudah? Sudah disebut ya? Nah, berarti kegiatan nomor tiga yang baru nanti disebutkan. Kira-kira apa nih? Next task is taking action to attract.
And next, we're going to work on encouraging insects. They're important for the biodiversity of the reserve.
Next task is taking action to attract. Attract, di sini tadi dengar kata apa?
Insect.
Ya, itu jawabannya. Tapi kuncinya adalah, true, good job.
Okay.
Kuncinya adalah tadi di encourage. Jadi attract atau encourage itu sama kayaknya kayak mendorong. So to, artinya menarik si insects untuk kegiatan tersebut untuk biodiversity gitu. Improve biodiversity. Well done, Macy. Gampang kan? Nah, kalau misalkan saya tahu kesulitannya apa, tapi kalian hanya tahu, oh jawabannya ini, tapi do you know why? Kalau misalkan nggak tahu jawabannya, saya cuma bilang, oh tadi ada di situ, di listening-nya, di audionya. Tapi kenapa? Kalau misalkan nggak tahu alasannya, jawabannya kayak gitu, nanti di IELTS exam-nya bingung. Karena berbeda dari mungkin latihan atau kok. Pasti, karena setiap konteks di listening akan selalu berbeda. Jadi, cobalah untuk cari tahu make sense-nya di mana. Lanjut? Siap untuk lanjut?
They certainly are.
Oh, and we're also running a project to identify the different species of butterflies.
What's the answer? Kalau ini katanya sama sih tadi dia bilang.
Butterfly.
Exactly. Yes. Good job. Tadi Macy, tadi dengarnya apa? Kata kunci.
Ada tadi persamaan sama type. Apa ya? Jadi saya memang lebih fokus ke jawabannya, jadi yang apanya lupa.
Yeah, it's okay. Let's hear it, yeah.
They're important for the biodiversity of the reserve.
They certainly are.
Oh, and we're also running a project to identify the different species of butterflies.
Different species. Jadi, yeah. Dan juga tadi dia bilang identify. Sedangkan di question juga identify. Tapi dengan ing ya, jadi identifying. Kadang ada yang sama, ada yang juga berbeda. Jadi harus pay attention to the synonym. Harus benar-benar perhatiin sama sinonimnya. Kalau enggak, mentang-mentang katanya sama, taunya artinya berbeda gitu kan. Jadi harus tahu maksudnya gimana. Sejauh ini betul. Okay, let's see number five.
Visit the reserve. You might be interested in taking part in that.
Sure. I was involved in something similar where I used to live, counting all the species of moths. I'd enjoy that.
Another job we're doing at the reserve is replacing the wall.
Another job. Berarti kita udah move sama activity selanjutnya. Jadi jangan fokus ke nomor 4. Kalau udah bilang another, atau biasanya move to a new activity.
On the southern side, between the parking area and our woodshed, it was badly damaged in a storm last month.
Okay.
Okay, wait.
Sure. I was involved in something similar where I used to live, counting all the species of moths. I'd enjoy that.
Another job we're doing at the reserve is replacing the wall on the southern side.
Okay. Ada kata-kata yang mirip dengan building anew, bangun sesuatu yang baru. Building anew.
Okay. Parking.
No.
Parking. Site.
No. Coba kita dengar lagi.
Yeah. Okay.
Enjoy that.
Another job we're doing at the reserve is replacing the wall on the southern side.
Southern.
Building a new one. Kata kuncinya, kunci jawabannya ada di kata yang mirip dengan building a new. Dengan mudah menyerah dong. Building a new.
Apa ya? Parking sama. Lot. Park. Gak mungkin.
No. Anyone?
Dia one word ya.
Coba.
I'd enjoy that.
Another job we're doing at the reserve is replacing the wall on the southern side.
Oh, kata kuncinya ada di replacing. Ya, udah dikasih dua clues, tiga malah. And two times. Ingat ya, di IELTS itu cuma satu kali listening. Nggak ada kalian nggak ngerti terus oh play lagi dong. No, kalau di ujiannya one time only. Building a new. Ayo apa coba lagi.
Interested in taking part in that?
Sure. I was involved in something similar where I used to live, counting all the species of moths. I'd enjoy that.
Another job we're doing at the reserve is replacing the wall on the southern side.
Replacing what?
That.
Another job we're doing at the reserve is replacing the wall on the southern side.
Replacing what? Menggantikan apa?
The word.
What?
The word, yeah.
Almost.
Oh my god.
Absentnya
oh, I
jelas
see. Tuh. Iya, yeah, iya. Yeah. The wall. Dinding,
the wall.
Ya.
Wall.
The wall.
Jawabannya wall. Good job, Macy. Oh, what should I call you?
The wall.
Wall. Jawabannya wall. Jadi replacing, apakah sama dengan building a new?
Yes.
Ya, sama kan? Mirip-mirip. Jangan terlalu terpaku dengan, oh ini nggak mirip banget. Tapi intinya adalah konteksnya itu mirip gitu loh. Replacing, menggantikan dengan membangun yang baru, ya mirip. Walaupun kalau kalian fokus dengan jawaban yang lain atau di dialog ini, nanti kalian akan bingung. Sedangkan di Peter bilang, another job we're doing at the reserve is replacing the wall on the southern side. Nggak mungkin kan building a new southern. Kalau building a new pasti diikutin dengan kata benda, bukan betul, kata betul. Sifat atau kata you know, tempat gitu, atau arah gitu. Southern kita arah ya, masa membangun arah. Jadi harus yang logic gitu. Oke, 1-5 selesai. Karena saya belum makan pagi dan siang, dan sekarang udah jam 2 siang. Ya, demi kalian loh guys, makanya kalian di sini harus benar-benar manfaatkan kelas yang gratis. Kalau kalian kebingungan, kesusahan, jangan menyerah. Jangan merasa bahwa kalian itu susah gitu loh untuk mengerti IELTS. Ingat kalian itu pengen punya IELTS dan dapetin IELTS untuk apa? Harus mengingat kembali. Oke, untuk kelas pertama saya sudahkan dulu ya, sudahi dulu. Terima kasih atas partisipasinya. Saya harap next meeting kalian itu lebih semangat dan juga lebih lebih apa ya? Lebih tahu mau ngapain gitu kan? Seperti yang saya bilang, IELTS itu latihannya gitu-gitu aja. Nggak ada sesuatu yang istimewa. Ya, listening, reading, writing, speaking. Udah gitu-gitu aja. Oke. Okay. Mungkin take a picture ya. Kalau kalian nggak keberatan, saya akan screenshot. It's okay. Mau, you can open up your camera or not, that's fine. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. Oke. Terima kasih ya. Nanti next meeting kalian harus lebih semangat lagi. Oke.
Terima kasih.
Terima kasih ya, Kak.
Terima kasih, Kak.
Terima kasih.